We are back in Pittsburgh, where the Rangers played earlier this season and lost 1-0. Henrik Lundqvist, fifth in the NHL in goals against average and fifth in save percentage. And with 10 wins. And across the way, Marc-Andre Fleury coming off a real good win in his last game, and they're hoping he can build off that. Now, last game, Mark Recchi, who's wearing an A as an alternate captain, was scratched, was a healthy scratch.
Jim, he's off to a tough start. He's got two goals on the season. He also got off to a slow start last year with one goal in just his first 14 games, and so he's back in there tonight.
Tonight's game is brought to you in high definition by Panasonic. It's time to bring back family time. Panasonic, ideas for life. Sidney Crosby opens up for the Penguins. The Rangers open up with Jaromir Jagr's line. Jagr on the right wing with Brandon Dubinsky in the middle and Marcel Hossa on the left side.
Last time these two teams played against one another, Crosby and Malkin were on the same line, but they've been broken up.
Sikora's on the wing. Crosby's pass was blocked. Stahl and Roosevelt, the defensive pair. Long shot. Scuderi, save, rebound, went off the post.
Crosby thought it was in.
Yes, he had his arms raised. The referee gave the safe sign that the puck did not go in. Roosevelt moves it around to Shanahan. The Penguins come awfully close on the rebound chance.
Yeah, that was a good first save by Lundqvist, but the rebound directly in front, and Crosby just comes out of nowhere to get the rebound and go off the post.
Avery on the forecheck. Rangers have Gomez, Avery, and Shanahan on with Girardi and Tootin. Turn the other way, Gonchar with the intercept. George Larocque with Maxime Talbot and Jarkko Ruutu. This is an icing on the Rangers. We're a minute 19 seconds into the game, and the Penguins came awfully close.
Yeah, the shot from the point gets through, and Lundqvist makes the save, and there was Crosby. Crosby just gets away from Dubinsky, and just off the inside of the post and out the other way.
Wow.
That close.
Mark Eaton kept it into Mark Recchi. Recchi with Malkin and Jordan Stahl. Shot blocked.
Damn, that's a fresh line after the Rangers iced the puck. Pittsburgh put fresh players on the ice.
Tootin with a hit. We've seen Tootin against Malkin quite frequently. Two young Russian players played together on Russian national teams. Here's Shanahan looking. Shanahan pass through. Save by Fleury. Paul Mara came in from the right point. Nice pass from Shanahan. Here's Gomez stuff in try. He stopped. That shot by Prucha is blocked. Gomez shot, save, Fleury, it's behind him and cleared out of the crease by Eaton. Now it's the Rangers' turn to come close. Fleury lost his stick, it's in the corner. They try to get it for him. The puck is cleared all the way down. It'll be an icing on Pittsburgh. This time the Rangers came within inches of scoring.
Well, we talked how the Rangers' defensemen have become more involved in the offense. And Shanahan, with a lot of patience, little dumping, now here they go. Gomez always seems to be the first man in on the puck lately, and there's the patience of Shanahan, the perfect read to Mara coming in. And Fleury makes a good save, and then the Rangers just didn't stop. They just kept going. Gomez again, boy, he has been quick. He has been on the puck. He just seems, doesn't he, Sam? He seems
yes.
Like he's the first man in on the forecheck.
Look at this configuration. Chris Drury is on with Dubinsky and Jagr.
Well, Jagr is going to play on a lot of different lines tonight. Tom Rennie's going to move him around quite a bit. And this is, as you mentioned, a new one.
Good feed to Strudwick. He waits. He shoots and a blocker save made by Fleury. Dubinsky bumped Fleury as Dubinsky skated through the crease. Good keep in by Strudwick. Jagr with a puck. Here's the boost from the crowd. Gets it to Paul Mara. Works it behind the net. Gonchar let it go, and Jagr played it. Puck deflects to Gonchar. He plays it off the boards, and is poked down the ice by Mark Recchi. Mara goes back to play it.
Now, the first shift of this game was the Crosby line, and they had a good shift. That's where Crosby hit the post. They had a lot of pressure on the Rangers in their own zone. The second two shifts, though, the next couple of shifts, have been all Rangers.
Rangers' fourth line is out. Blair Betts centering Colton Orr and Ryan Hallwig. Back the other way, Adam Hall, former Ranger, fires it into the corner. Off the boards, it's chipped ahead by Brooks Orpik, the defenseman. Taken by Girardi, able to work it ahead of Orr. Orr is bumped by Eric Christensen, and then Hallwig takes a run at Christensen. Hall brings it across, and the Penguins are offside. 3:44 gone by in the game. There is no score. Rangers, with that flurry of shots moments ago, have four shots on goal. New York Rangers hockey is being brought to you by Budweiser, who thanks you for being a designated driver. There's Adam Hall.
Mm-hmm. Getting an opportunity with the Penguins after going from the Rangers to Minnesota a year ago. The Penguins, not unlike the Rangers in the early part of the season, where they're really trying to find somebody who can score other than Crosby and Malkin and Gonchar on defense.
Puck deflected off the Penguins bench, and they'll bring it back in the Pittsburgh zone for a faceoff. Sidney Crosby, who is second in the National Hockey League in scoring to Vinny LeCavalier. The guy, as Joe said, can do it all. He is the captain of the team here in his third year in the National Hockey League.
But it's got to be a little bit tough on him, Joe. He's trying to carry the load for this team, and as you mentioned a moment ago, they're not scoring much outside of him and Gonchar.
You know what, Sam, though? I mean, for a 20-year-old kid, and he's the captain, and talking to him this morning, he says, you know what? It's not bad to play in these low-scoring games.
Penalty.
Learn.
It's on the Penguins. Gomez was tripped up, and right to the penalty box goes Ryan Malone.
Yeah.
Got the stick in the skates of Gomez.
Gomez will get tripped right there. And so, again, Gomez on the puck and skating and moving. And when he does that, Gomez is a tough player to play against and defend against.
Tom Rennie is still looking for the right combinations on the power play. And he sends out Gomez, Yager, Shanahan up front with Girardi at one point and Roosevelt at the other point.
Well, and his thinking on this, and I asked him, he said, you got two right-handed shooting defensemen out. And he says, well, that's okay. He says, I don't care who plays which side. It doesn't matter. He said, but you've got with Yager on that other side, he can feed now either defenseman for the one-timer. The key is they have to shoot when he sets them up.
Rangers power play 1-for-14 in the last three games. Gomez for Shanahan. His shot was blocked and cleared by Rob Scuderi.
And Sam, just getting back to Crosby for just a second to finish that thought. You know, he says he's not real worried. He says it's good to play in low-scoring games, and he thinks back to last February when they had points in 18 straight games. So he thinks they can put together a streak of that nature again.
Yager controls the puck. Now Gomez. Shanahan in front. Yager to Gomez. Back to Yager. Slides it in front for Shanahan. It was broken up. Crosby is on as a penalty killer. That's something he's added to his repertoire this year. Backhander Girardi. Save. Roosevelt Yager. He fired it through the crease. Shanahan to Gomez. Gomez against Crosby. Now he's picked up by Gonchar. Roosevelt keeps it in. Penguins have given up 7 power play goals in the last 4 games. 15-for-22. Here is Girardi. Wrist shot blocked. Talbot with a good sliding block. Crosby gets out. 2-on-1 with Talbot. Roosevelt back. Crosby. Talbot scores. Oh, what a pass from Sidney Crosby. And Maxim Talbot scores a shorthanded goal. And the Penguins take a 1-0 lead.
Well, Brendan Shanahan lets that one go back to the point. Now this is Girardi who gets his shot blocked by Talbot, and then Crosby with the pressure, and here he goes. The great speed, and what a pass. There's not many that pass it better than Sidney Crosby either, but Talbot made the initial play blocking the shot, and then he just took off up the ice. Sidney Crosby waited for him to get in the open. Talbot goes right past Roosevelt in the perfect pass and just a little tap in. A shorthanded goal, and that's one of the reasons why Crosby is killing penalties this season.
And it's a franchise record 19-game point scoring streak for Sidney Crosby. He failed to score opening night, and he's scored in every game since. Talbot gets his 5th from Crosby at 5:51, a shorthanded goal, and the Penguins have the early lead. Third straight game, the Rangers have given up the first goal of the game.
And pretty early in the game, yeah. Sam. They gave up an early one in
ooh. Malkin with a takeaway. Got it to Recchi. Recchi shoots, save. Rebound, batted down. It went in, no goal. That was batted down by Malkin from at least shoulder height and immediately waved off. 6:30 gone by, first period. Penguins have a shorthanded goal. They lead the Rangers 1-0.
Here's our Panasonic digital replay. That's Mark Recchi with the puck. The shot off the shoulder, and then Malkin just bats it in with his hand. It wouldn't have counted on a couple of fronts.
Right.
Over the crossbar, and you can't bat it in with the open hand. No goal.
It's time to bring back family time. Panasonic ideas for life with the digital replay of the no goal. A little over 6.5 minutes gone by in the first. Rangers trail 1-0. They have their fourth line on with Betts, Orr, and Holwig. Mara and Strudwick on defense. Fleury drops it off to Chris Letang. Just called up, his second game since being called up. Played some games last season.
Well, they sorely needed a right-handed shooting defenseman in the lineup. They were playing with six left-handed shooters. So he's a good offensive player.
Shot from the point by Orpik was blocked. Mara gets the puck around the boards. Letang is there to keep it in. Letang has had a great junior career. One of the top players on the Canadian World Junior Championship team. Malkin moving, shooting, blocked. Stuff in by Recchi is stopped. And the puck is still loose. Recchi behind the net. And it's taken back by Mara.
Yeah, Sam, he captained that team, Letang. Well, he's a kid that they have high hopes for.
Orpik. Penguins with a record of 8-10-1 coming off a 3-2 win over the Islanders. Good play by Shanahan on the takeaway from Letang. Avery moves away from Crosby. Gomez gets it out to Roosevelt for Rister that goes wide. Chased down by Avery. Stahl with a drive. Stick save by Fleury. Now Gomez with a shot that's blocked by Crosby. Breaks out 3-on-2. Crosby against Roosevelt. Down the middle, Ryan Malone. He gets sent flying and a penalty called on Roosevelt. Good rush down the ice. Boy, a quick transition by the Penguins. Here's Gonchar on the delayed penalty. Extra skater on. It's out to Malkin. Now Mark Eaton. Gonchar looking. Into the middle, the shot went wide by Sikora. Comes around to Malkin. Extra time for Pittsburgh on the delayed penalty. Gonchar set up. Deflection. Shot by Crosby. He scores! Sidney Crosby has gotten off to a great start in this game.
Sam, it was Crosby that blocked the shot initially in his own zone and then led the rush. And then with Pittsburgh and the extra player on the ice, that group of five Rangers on the ice, they were tired. A lot of standing around. They were tired out, and the Penguins just kept moving the puck around. And eventually Crosby from the other side puts it in. As Lundqvist couldn't get all the way over, so Crosby blocked the shot in his own zone initially and then rushed down the ice to lead the 3-on-2. They draw the penalty, a delayed penalty, and Crosby finishes things off.
A great job by the Penguins of keeping the play alive on the delayed penalty call. They got an extra skater on, and they kept the puck away from the Rangers and finally cashed in. Crosby now with a goal and an assist in the game.
Yeah, you could tell that Ranger fivesome, they were out of gas, you know, standing around, and Pittsburgh had a lot of time to try and make plays.
Great start to the game for the Penguins, who lead 2-0.
Malkin was the extra player that came on the ice. That's a lot of talent.
Crosby with a goal from Sikora and Gonchar at 8:51. And play is whistled down. 10:27 to go in this first period.
Well, again, Crosby, you'll see him. He was right there. Got right in the shooting lane and blocked the shot and then led to this. 3-on-2. It would have been a penalty against Roosevelt. And then the Penguins have time, and they just start moving the puck around. And it was actually a missed shot on the play by Sikora. He didn't get all of it. It went off the heel of his stick right over to Crosby on the other side.
Crosby is the 11th goal of the season. 2 points tonight give him 30. He's 2 points behind Vinny LeCavalier, who leads the league with 32 points. Georges Laroque around the net. Rangers will see Vinny LeCavalier on Wednesday night when the Rangers visit the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Well, he had a great season a year ago, and he's just starting off the same way.
Laroque out to the point to Orpik. Now Letang with a shot that's blocked by Nigel Dawes. They were teammates on the Canadian World Junior team. Dawes with a shot to Letang. Take away by Malkin. Drives to the net. Save made by Lundqvist.
Malkin came off the bench. The Rangers were changing, and no one was there to get the loose puck.
Recky to Malkin for a drive wide. Long rebound out to Gonchar. Jordan Staal. Jordan Staal has not had a point in his last 12 games.
He's back on the wing, Sam. He's played most of this year at center. Last year when he had the big offensive year, he played wing, and he played with Malkin. So they decided to put him back on the wing and put him back on a line with Malkin to see if he can get going offensively.
And the Staal parents have made the long drive down from Canada to see their two of their sons, play here tonight. 8:56 to go in the first. Want to correct some information we gave you earlier. The streak, the 19-game point-scoring streak by Sidney Crosby, is a personal best right. For him.
His landlord.
The franchise record belongs to Mario at 46.
Yeah, that's his landlord. He's still living with Mario, his third year here in Pittsburgh. He says, it's great. Why should I change?
And we apologize to Mario.
I think he'll be okay.
He'll be up in the booth here pounding on us. What, you forget me already?
Never. He won't be forgotten.
Never. You're right about that. Staal. Mark Staal moving in against Peter Sikora. Now against Sergei Gonchar. Try to get it to Gomez. Staal has it. To Avery. In deep. Ryan Malone with a good hit on Roosevelt. Shanahan goes back to get the puck, sending it back in. Rangers have to touch up and get onside. Meanwhile, Eaton sends it deep into the Rangers' zone. Roosevelt. Big time pressure, turnover, and Crosby would stop. Sikora with good pressure on Roosevelt. Here's Sikora, save! Made by Lundqvist. Sikora set up by Sidney Crosby.
And Sam, a little bit of confusion between Roosevelt and Dubinsky, and give plenty of credit to Sikora because he wouldn't give up. But the two of them end up back in the corner. Roosevelt on one side, and Dubinsky comes in to help out. And here comes Dubinsky, and they kind of lose the puck. And then what a save. What a save by Lundqvist again on Crosby. Every shift.
Along the boards is set up for the quick shot by Roberts as a save by Lundqvist. Around the Yager, it's knocked away. Good pressure by the Penguins. Rangers able to clear out. At one point, the Rangers were out shooting the Penguins. And now the Penguins are out shooting the Rangers 10-6. It was 4-1 at one point. Icing on the Rangers. Penguins have picked up their game. They're controlling the play right now. 7:31 to go. And fans, if you're looking for great Rangers tickets, find them online at msgticketexchange.com. You can purchase tickets directly from Rangers season ticket holders. It's the only team-sanctioned online resale service. Features a secure environment, convenient email delivery. Visit msgticketexchange.com today. And a little equipment work being done on the skate and the strap of Henrik Lundqvist.
You can tell the strength of this Pittsburgh team when they get in and forecheck. And Crosby, every shift he's been on the ice, something has been happening.
Away with a puck, Dubinsky.
And pardon me, it was Sikora that took the shot that I mentioned. He dug it out of the corner. It was Sikora that had the chance in front.
Betts has come on. Here's Crosby. Two-on-one develops. Saved by Lundqvist. Reaches behind him. Boy, Crosby is so quick in the transition.
Yep.
He gets the puck and he's gone.
And what happened on the play, Strudwick was caught flat-footed. There's Strudwick. He's flat-footed against Crosby. And Crosby, with that powerful speed, just takes off the other way. Letang starts to play in the corner. And here comes Crosby. Boy, oh boy, you've got to be moving back. It's so hard because he comes out of nowhere with that explosive speed.
Shot by Letang, gets through, and a save by Lundqvist, and he holds on. Faceoff win by Evgeny Malkin. Set up Chris Letang for the shot from the point.
Right off the faceoff, Malkin. And that puck comes through. Lundqvist able to just gobble it up.
Letang was a third-round pick in the 2005 draft, just 20 years old. Odd man rushes in the game, 3 for Pittsburgh. 2 of them have led to goals. Malkin. Rangers have Drury on with Hossa and Pruka. So Tom Rennie doing a little bit of line shifting and changing here. Strudwick, pressured by Jordan Staal.
Well, he hasn't been able to get that line. Remember, he's the visiting coach. He has not been able to get Blair Betts out against Crosby. And so far, no one has been able to stop Crosby or slow him down.
Here is Gomez with Avery. Avery goes to the net. That shot is high and off the glass. Chased down by Roosevelt in deep. Off the boards, Gonchar stopped it. Gomez took it away. Feeding it, Avery, save, and the rebound cleared aside. Good play by Gomez and Avery. Back the other way, Larocque against Roosevelt. Roosevelt moves it out of the zone. Sent the other way by Talbot. Shanahan reverses to Mark Staal. Penguins with 12 shots in the first period. Roosevelt. Dubinsky a little behind Drury, and the Penguins take over. Jágr is on with Dubinsky and Drury here.
Damn, and those 12 shots, it does not include the post that Crosby hit on his first shift of the game. What a period he's having. Wow.
Fleury mishandled the puck. Dubinsky got it to Jágr. Jágr comes off the boards. Checked by Erik Christensen. Penalty upcoming on the Penguins. Dubinsky against Orpik. And the whistle. Rangers still had possession, but the hooking signal is given. And the Rangers get a power play as Adam Hall goes off.
It was Jágr, I believe, that drew the penalty. Jágr has been, I think, handling the puck better than he has all season long. Skating, handling it. Rangers will go into power play, down 2.
First time in the last 6 games, the Penguins have scored the first goal of the game. Sidney Crosby assisted on the first goal. Shorthanded goal by Maxim Talbot. And then he scored a goal to make it 2-0. Now the Rangers on the power play. Adam Hall for hooking at 14:55. Can't say I agree with the call. Kind of weak. But the Rangers on the power play. Dubinsky drives to the net, and it was knocked away. Shot by Tootin, save. Out to the point, save by Fleury on Mara. Mara and Tootin, Dubinsky, Avery, and Drury for the Rangers power play. That last deflection went off the side of the net. Ryan Malone, Jordan Staal, Mark Eaton, and Sergei Gonchar for Pittsburgh. They changed 3 of the 4. Now Malone goes off, and they change all 4.
And this power play unit for the Rangers, just getting the puck, shooting it, and getting to the net. Very basic. Remember, more times than not, Sam, that's what works.
Yeah. Remember last year when Crosby, first 2 years, he didn't kill penalties. Now he's out there, and boy, is he dangerous. A takeaway and a clear.
Well, he's so strong on the board, so he can make the plays on the boards. And then with his smarts and, you know, his ability to just take off and go shorthanded, which we saw early in this period, it makes him a dangerous player.
50 seconds to go on the power play. 3:55 to go, first period. Gomez takes it deep, gets it to Jágr. Gomez, Yager, Shanahan, quick shot wide. Girardi's in deep. Girardi and Roosevelt, the point men. Gomez swings it around. Shanahan keeps it moving to Yager. Ryan Whitney and Rob Scuderi, the defense pair for Pittsburgh, with Jordan Staal and Ryan Malone. Gomez looking, try to slide it in front, and it went through. Girardi winds it behind the net to Gomez. Gomez against Ryan Whitney. Out to Roosevelt. Now Girardi. Back to Roosevelt. To Yager. Gomez in front. Yager moving. Pass tipped. And the power play is over. Good penalty kill for Pittsburgh. Rangers 0 for 2 on a power play in the game. They trail 2-0.
Four of those five players for Pittsburgh are tired. Now Hall gets it out of his own zone.
Recovered by Tootin. Rangers, the last few games have been slow to get their game going. Here's Pruka coming in. A shot blocked by Orpik. Betts on with Dawes and Pruka. Puck deflects into the corner.
Damn, you know, Tom Rennie said before the game, told us before the game, they're going to have to play better in this game than they did the previous two.
Here's Larocque with Recchi. Lundqvist steers it into the corner. Malkin bumped along the boards by Pruka. Rangers come out with a puck. Betts, now Dawes. Kang swings it around the boards. Dawes gets there. It's taken away by Recchi. Try to play it to Larocque. Larocque wasn't looking. He was going to the bench for a change. Rangers take over. Drury gets it through to Strudwick. Marek Malik remains out for the Rangers, along with Ryan Callahan and Marty Straka. All three skated this morning.
Looks like at least another week for those, for at least for Callahan and for Straka.
Hallway. Bumped along the boards by Orpik. Drury against Gary Roberts. Roberts tried to lift it ahead. Knocked down, then kept in. Orpik has it back. A minute 25 to go in the first period. Pittsburgh with a 2-0 lead. Here's Fedor Tootin.
Now, Pittsburgh's coming off a game in which they played maybe their best game in a long, long time against the Islanders, the 3-2 win.
Gomez, a nice rush. And that shot goes wide by Staal. Shanahan's pass knocked down. Gonchar there to play it. Sends out Crosby. Crosby against Staal, centered. Tipped. Sikora tried to put it in front. Rangers take over. Under a minute to go in the first period. 2-0 Pittsburgh. Maxime Talbot and Sidney Crosby, the goal scorers. Crosby with a goal and an assist in the game. Here's Dan Girardi sending it in. Scuderi ridden to the boards by Hossa. Dubinsky drives to the net, knocked away. Shot by Tootin, save Fleury. Dubinsky, Hossa. Yager trying to stuff it in, it's cleared behind. Big time pressure by the Rangers, but Fleury made a couple of saves and got help from the defense. The
Rangers are getting their best chances when their defensemen come in deep and get involved in the offense. We've seen Tootin and Girardi and some of the other players do it, but they trail here in the first.
Penguins fans like it here at Mellon Arena. The Penguins get the first two goals of the game. Sidney Crosby setting up Maxime Talbot for a shorthanded goal and then scoring a goal himself. And he now has a 19-game point scoring streak.
He was just dominant in the first period. Started with the first shift when he ended up hitting the post. He thought it was in, it was not. And then shift after that. Next one they had to kill. The Rangers had that early power play and they had a few chances, but the block shot by Talbot. Crosby picking up the loose puck. Talbot getting off the ice and hustling back down into the other end and then just waiting for Crosby to set him up with an easy shorthanded goal. And so for Tom Rennie and his team, again, another period where his team didn't play real well. And that's three games in a row. And then this is the end of the period where the Rangers had some good pressure. Hossa in front. Yager was there. Fleury is coming off a good game. He's had one of those up and down seasons thus far, the young goaltender. And so the Rangers finished the period with some pressure, but still it remains 2-0.
So the Penguins with the early lead. And it's time now for the Hockey Night Live Mercedes Intermission Report. And we are joined by Rangers assistant coach Perry Byrne. Perry, in looking at that first period, Sidney Crosby did a lot of good things. Any changes, anything you want to do differently against Crosby in the second period?
Well, obviously, we don't want to give him the kind of chances that he had the first period. I think, you know, we'll have to tighten up defensively all around. Not the kind of period that we wanted to have to start this game.
What do you want to do differently, Perry?
Well, I think, you know, you saw a little bit of at the tail end of the period where we got pucks deep. We made sure that we had a third guy high. We cycled the puck well, got some pucks to the net, and I think we put some pressure on Pittsburgh. But, you know, we need to do that on a consistent basis.
Thank you, Perry. Good luck the rest of the game.
Thank you.
Rangers assistant coach Perry Byrne. The Mercedes Hockey Night Live intermission report continues right after this. Welcome back to Pittsburgh. New York Rangers hockey is brought to you in part by HIP Health Plan of New York. Now that's HIP. And by Nissan. Live life, live big. The Nissan Armada with room for 8. Nissan, shift your ride. Sam and Joe here in Pittsburgh. No Al Troutwig. John Giannone is over on the radio side, so it's just you and me, Joe.
I know, Al. I called Al. He said I could have his points if I get it right.
Henrik Lundqvist, 2.22 goals against average. NHL's second best over the last four seasons. Who's first? Mika Kiprusoff, Marty Brodeur, Dominic Hasek. Mm. 1, 2, or 3 for the fans. Mm. Text 1, 2, or 3 to MSGNY 67469.
That's a pretty good question.
Very good question.
Who do you think it is?
I have an idea. I'll let you know after the second period.
Okay.
Kiprusoff, Brodeur, or Hasek, remember the choices. You'll be asking me right in the end of the intermission.
That's
okay,
true.
Tom Rennie, see the intensity? He wants his team to pick it up.
Well,
they need to pick it up.
Sam, if there's anything to take out of previous games when the Rangers haven't played all that well in the first period, is the fact that they've been able to dominate second periods, both against New Jersey and the Flyers, and they're going to have to get that going again because Pittsburgh spent too much time in the Rangers' zone in the first period.
Betts, Orr, Hollweg, Girardi, and Tootin open up for the Rangers. Talbot, Ruutu, Larocque.
Yeah,
fourth line against fourth line.
Yeah, we could see some fireworks here.
Orpik and Letang on defense for Pittsburgh, dumped in by Hollweg. But it hit the netting, and they'll bring the puck out to center ice for a face-off. Third meeting of the season between these two teams. There's big George Larocque.
He is big, 245 pounds. He says he scored the game-winning goal against the Islanders. He said, I get 15 to 20 points every year. He says, that's better than all the other tough guys in the league. Proud of that.
Tootin fanned on the pass. Larocque takes it away. Tootin ties him up. Able to move the puck. And Hallway gets out with Colton Orr. Orr centers. Comes out of the zone. Betts had skated through the slot.
Now the Rangers were
behind him. Sorry.
Yeah, the Rangers were changing their two defensemen. That's why there wasn't anyone there to keep the puck in.
Dubinsky. Quick shot off the chest of Fleury. Dubinsky has it back. Centers. Score! Oh, what a play by Brandon Dubinsky as he sets up Michael Roosevelt for the goal. And it's 2-1.
Sam, I'll tell you what, Tom Rennie did a heck of a job here. He made a key line change to get that line out there against the Penguins' fourth line. They were able to get the puck in the zone, and then they made a line change. Fourth line comes off. This line with Jágr on it, Dubinsky comes on the ice. Fourth line still out there for Pittsburgh. And as we've talked about, the defenseman moving into the play, and Roosevelt ends up with his fifth of the year. So the Rangers with a great line change to get the advantage with the Jágr line out against the fourth line for Pittsburgh. And they turn it into a goal by Michael Roosevelt. Great start to the period.
Great shot by Roosevelt, but what a play Dubinsky made. Recovering the puck after the save by Fleury. So Dubinsky with his second assist of the season. He's now had points in three of the last five games as he starts to get going offensively. Hossa to Jágr. Jágr takes it deep against Ryan Whitney. Try to center, was deflected away. Roosevelt with a long shot, knocked down. And Ryan Whitney moves it out. Well, to start the period, at least, it seems as if the Rangers got the message from Coach Tom Rennie.
Now again, the line change was key, though.
Jágr. Gomez just on, forced back by Scuderi. Now Hossa looking, Gomez calling for it. The centering feed was blocked. Jager's got it. In front, Ryan Malone able to intercept. Sikora dumps it in. So Roosevelt gets his fifth from Dubinsky at 49 seconds, and the Penguins lead cut to 2-1. Chipped out of the zone, Avery plays it. Avery across with Gomez. Mark Eaton.
It almost looked to me like it should have been a penalty as Avery went down, but the referee was right there.
Offside, offside Pittsburgh. Recchi out of the play. A little over 2 minutes gone by in this second period.
Now the Rangers defense, they continue to get involved in the play. I think Avery was looking for a play. And meanwhile, the shot by Roosevelt goes all the way through. Did it hit Fleury? There's some bumping in front. I'm not sure if his own man bumped into Fleury or whether it was the Ranger player, but puck I don't think ever got through to Fleury. They've worked an awful lot with Fleury on staying square to the puck and controlling rebounds.
Kruka in deep. Now Nigel Dawes. The line is Drury with Kruka and Dawes. Good keep in by Paul Mara. And now the Penguins able to get clear. Mark Eaton. Mara shoved by Christensen, gets away. All the way down the ice it goes. It'll be an icing on the Rangers. New York Rangers hockey is being brought to you by Budweiser, who thanks you for being a designated driver. Peter Prucha, who scored a goal the other night, his first from since opening night of the season. And in the crowd, as we mentioned, there the Henry and Linda Stahl are here. They made the trip down from Sudbury.
Today, yeah, they watched the young son play last night for Sudbury. A 3-2, I believe they lost 3-2.
Penalty on the Rangers. They put the puck right into the crowd in the defensive zone. Chris Drury did it. He's going off. Power play for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, Sikora was right there. Drury had to move it quickly. The puck looked like it was on edge. And Drury up and over the glass. So the Rangers start the period with a quick goal to get within one. And now their penalty killing is going to have to go to work.
And watch out. Penguins are so dangerous. They have scored in all but one game this season on the power play. At least one power play goal. Gonchar, big drive blocked by Tootin. Drury delay of the game at 2:55. First power play of the game for Pittsburgh. Gonchar and Ryan Whitney play the points. Sikora, Crosby, and Malkin up front. Crosby. Rangers have Betts and Hossa with Tootin and Girardi. Ryan Whitney across to Gonchar for the drive. Save! Rebound in front! Save! Oh, great save! As Lundqvist robbed Peter Sikora.
And Sikora can't believe it. But Lundqvist got some help, I believe, from one of his players. I think Sikora had trouble getting his stick free in front. The shot by Gonchar. I think it was Girardi that put enough pressure on Sikora. So the first time he went to try and get the puck in, he missed it because of the pressure by Girardi. And then the second time, Lundqvist was over there to make the save.
Rangers able to clear all the way down. Gonchar back for the puck. Gonchar fires in. Rangers have Mark Stahl and Michael Roosevelt on with Shanahan and Avery. Whitney across to Gonchar. Crosby. Backhands it in front for Ryan Whitney, and it just went off Whitney's stick back the other way. Avery, 3-on-2, Rangers across. Peter Roosevelt, he scores! Michael Roosevelt! with his second goal of the game, a shorthanded goal, and the game is tied at two.
There's the Rangers defense again joining the rush. Shorthanded, they're able to get the puck out of their zone. It just goes out the other way. Here come the Rangers, and what a pass coming up from Avery. Watch Avery, hold it, and then a hard, quick pass. Right in the perfect position so that Roosevelt didn't have to stop it to shoot. That's Avery, he looks, and then the perfect pass, and what a shot. You can see the goaltender having to go to his right. The shot came back to his left over his glove. And for Michael Roosevelt, two goals in the first 4 minutes of this period. And the Rangers have come back to tie it.
Joe and I were talking while we were away in commercial during the intermission. We felt Roosevelt struggled in the first period.
He did.
He has found his game here in the second. Man, can he shoot it? And Avery with another point. Penguins move in, shot by Recchi, save! And Lundqvist had it go behind the net. Strudwick gets there and he clears all the way down.
Sam, how many times have we talked about it when Roosevelt, the way he can shoot the puck, and he doesn't shoot the puck enough on the power play. And I mentioned last game, when he's on the ice with Jágr, he almost always defers to Jágr with the pass instead of taking the shot.
Roosevelt gets the goal, his sixth of penalty on Pittsburgh. Girardi was taken down, delayed penalty on the Penguins.
Christensen will get called for tripping.
Power play Rangers, they got a good penalty kill and scored a shorthanded goal and now go on to power play.
You can see number 16 is Christensen. Watch
the stick right there on the skates. Down goes Girardi. Christensen gets called for tripping. And so the Rangers, boy, what a start to this period. What a start.
Everything going right. Christensen for tripping.
That's Mike Therrien, the head coach of the Pittsburgh Penguins. His team was good in the first period, yeah, but it's been all Rangers here to start the second.
5:11, the time of the penalty to Christensen. Roosevelt and Mara start at the points with Gomez, Shanahan, and Jágr up front. Shanahan.
Pardon me, Sam, but here's where you want to see, again, Roosevelt take the shot.
Gomez sets it up. Feeds Roosevelt. Shanahan's in front. Jágr. Gomez. Now Roosevelt, out to him, Jordan Staal. Staal and Hall, the forward pair for Pittsburgh. Jágr to Gomez. Across, Mara shoots, save! Oh, good save by Fleury. Nice pass from Gomez to Mara.
Yeah, he had to delay just for a split second. That allowed Fleury to get to the other side of the net and make the save.
Puck around the boards, Mara in deep. Winds it behind the net, comes through to Gomez. Gomez out to Roosevelt. Gomez has become the quarterback on this power play,
yes,
for the Rangers.
Jágr's down low.
Jágr to Gomez. Gomez holding. 50 seconds to go on the man advantage. Jágr trying to get in front. He lost the handle of the puck. Gomez sets up Roosevelt. Mara. Roosevelt. Back to Mara. Roosevelt again. Jágr's high in the slot.
Penalty killers are tired, Sam. Just standing there.
Gomez looking. High shot knocked down by Fleury with a glove.
Now you don't want to let Pittsburgh get a whistle. They're just standing around. They're so tired.
Roosevelt moving. Looking for a shooting lane. Doesn't have one. Feeds Mara. On to Shanahan behind the net. Off the boards to Jágr.
And Gonchar can't even skate. No energy left.
There's Shanahan. Can they take advantage? Power play is over. Jordan Staal gets to the puck. Tootin tried to keep it in, went off his glove into the Rangers bench. 7:18 gone by, second period. Rangers have come back to tie.
Here's a look at our Panasonic digital replay. The Rangers on the power play, moving the puck around, and Gomez has had the puck an awful lot. What a pass to the other side to Mara coming in from the point. Mara delayed for just an instant in getting the puck, and that allowed Fleury, who's very quick and athletic, to get over and make the save on Paul Mara. And then Adam Hall gets right in the shooting lane. That one hurt. That was the shot by Michael Roosevelt.
It's time to bring back family time. Panasonic Ideas for Life with our digital replay. Sean Avery, you got an assist earlier on that shorthanded goal by Roosevelt. That was, he now has points in five of his last six games. 8 points over the last six games for Sean Avery.
That pass he made was absolutely perfect. Not too hard, but hard enough to get it past the other player and to get it to Roosevelt right away in a perfect spot where he could shoot it.
Here's Sikora. Since he's come back from injury, Girardi up against Crosby. Now that's a change from the first period.
Yes.
First period is Roosevelt and Stahl against Crosby. Now it's Tootin and Girardi.
Girardi told me this morning in playing against Crosby, he said, you got to fight not getting too conservative and just backing up. He said, what you don't want to do is make a pass up the middle and don't give the puck away and try and play him strong.
Stahl made a nice move out of the zone against Malkin. Rangers across are offside. 11:35 to go in the second period. The game tied 2-2. Mark Stahl, we've been talking about him and playing against his brother with his parents in attendance. Certainly getting a lot of ice time. Had over 20 minutes of ice time in the game against Philadelphia. Jágr slowed down by Malkin. Dubinsky winds it to Jágr. Jágr turns. Oh, just missed. Hossa to the side of the net, and Hossa broke his stick.
Yeah, I think that might have caused him to not be able to finish on the play. Looked like the puck was right there for him.
Stahl, a good job to chip it and keep it in the zone away from Malkin, who was trying to break out. Roosevelt was stopped by Letang, and the puck deep in the Rangers zone. Started to say, since Sean Avery came back from his shoulder injury, Rangers are 6-1 with him in the lineup.
He's important, Sam.
Oh,
he does so many different things.
He's been something since being acquired by the Rangers last season. Shanahan tried to get it to Avery. Gomez pass gets through to Strudwick. Long shot wide. That nice play by Avery, but it just went off the stick of Shanahan. Good idea. Then Avery got tangled up with Eaton behind the play. Down come the Penguins. Good save by Lundqvist. Larocque behind the net against Strudwick. Gomez with good help gets away from Larocque.
That was a good play by George Larocque. He gloved that high rebound and knocked it down and kept the play alive.
Coming down to the midway point of the second period. Pittsburgh, two goals in the first. Rangers, two goals here in the second. Shot by Avery goes wide. Girardi comes all the way back to get the puck. Outlets up the middle of Blair Betts. Betts with Colton Orr. And it's gloved by Fleury at the top of the crease. 9:45 to go in the second. Little get together at the whistle.
Well, Sean Avery always around the front of the net trying to screen the goaltender. This one he tries to set up Shanahan and then gets involved with Eaton. And Eaton lets go of his stick so he wouldn't get called on the penalty. And later on the shift, remember that combination?
Gary Roberts, and Roberts.
Sean Avery.
Last time they met up in New York.
Yeah, this is what happened. They got started early in that game. And Avery later on, right here, draws a double minor against Roberts. And eventually the Rangers scored on that power play.
Betts wins the draw from Crosby. Shot by Tootin, saved by Fleury. Hallwig. This is a matchup that Tom Rennie doesn't mind whatsoever. Rangers fourth line against the Crosby line. Here goes Crosby. Now Malone. Feed to Sikori. Missed it. And Girardi moves it to the line. Kept in by Brooks Orpik. Shot went off a leg. Crosby. Bumped by Betts. Crosby, he's strong. Sets up Sikora, save made by Lundqvist.
Damn, his legs are so strong. It's tough to knock him off the puck.
Sent back in by Letang, and Hollig almost knocked Letang into the bench. Colton Orr sends it to Gomez. Rangers changing, and once again, that's the matchup that Tom Rennie doesn't mind. Rangers fourth line did a nice job. Gomez tried to center, intercepted by Malkin. Evgeny Malkin gets around Stahl. Picked up by Avery. One-hand shot, save. Gonchar to the rebound. Now Malkin. His pass tipped. Played by Mark Eaton. Jordan Stahl tied up by Roosevelt. Puck out in front. Recchi couldn't play it. Shanahan, good patience. Finds Avery. Avery with Stahl. Mark Stahl. Puck around the boards. Mark Stahl just went off. One of the few times in this game that Mark and Jordan have been on at the same time. Eaton to Jordan Stahl, who's not scored a point in his last 12 games and only 2 points this season, a goal and an assist. We've been talking about Mark Stahl a lot. Let's check out his sharp player profile, Joe. Let's see what he like. A favorite player growing up, as he told us during the interview, Rob Blake. First job, sod farmer. Favorite actor, one of your favorites, Will Ferrell.
Well, Will's good.
Battle along the boards. Strudwick lost sight of it. Larocque's got it. Shot it wide. Scuderi. In deep, Larocque. Dubinsky stayed with him. Strudwick deflected that pass in front. Good pressure by the Penguins with their fourth line. Out in front. Talbot shoots. Save made by Lundqvist. He was screened by Big George Larocque. Ruutu knocked down. Ruutu
and Dubinsky. There was going to be a penalty.
Dubinsky's first scrap since that ill-fated scrap with Luke Richardson.
Well, he got some lessons after that one from Colton Orr. And from Jason Strudwick. Got a couple of punches in. That's one in there.
It's a learning process.
Well, there's no question he's game.
Uh-oh. Yeah, Jason Strudwick looking on. He'll have to give him some instruction.
They'll be reviewing that again tomorrow. Started off pretty well, kid.
Well, as soon as the helmet
he's
comes
willing,
off,
you know?
He's at a disadvantage right away.
And he's willing. And that's the one thing about the way he plays. Now, he gets hit from behind there. See, that was the original penalty. And let's see if they'll even things up here. As Ruutu, without question, was going to get the first penalty. The referee had his arm up on the other side. And this was a good shift by the fourth line. That was, as you mentioned, Sam, George Larocque in front. There's the hit by Ruutu from behind. And let's see, the Rangers, it looks like, will end up with the power play. They went at it a long time, Ruutu and Dubinsky. And the original minor against Ruutu stands.
Yes.
So the Rangers get a power play out of this.
It'll be their fourth power play of the game. They're 0 for 3. 7:31 to go in this second period. Time of the penalties, 12:29. And the game tied 2-2. Penguins getting two goals in the first period. And the Rangers answering back with two goals here in the second period. Each team now has a shorthanded goal in the game. Ruutu gets 2 for boarding, 5 for fighting. Dubinsky, 5 for fighting. And the Rangers on the power play have Gomez, Jágr, Shanahan, Roosevelt, and Mara. Mara outlets to Roosevelt. Roosevelt with both goals for the Rangers. One a shorthanded goal.
Feed him.
Nice play by Adam Hall. Take away and a clear.
Feed Roosevelt and let him keep shooting.
Gomez, Talbot, and Ryan Malone on for Pittsburgh with Gonchar and Eaton. Jágr's got the puck. Gomez looking toward the net. Shanahan is down low. Jágr gets it out to Mara and gets it back.
Yes, this is the change on the power play.
Here's Gomez.
Mara on this first unit instead of Girardi. Right. So you've got a left-handed shot and a right-handed shot on defense.
Nice play by Roosevelt to keep it in. Gonchar able to get it out. And good pressure by Ryan Malone. Almost took it away. Now the Penguins do. And Talbot clears it down. 45 seconds to go in the power play for the Rangers. 6:10 to go in the second. Tied 2-2. Peter Prucha fires it in. Scuderi swings it around to Ryan Whitney, and he clears it. Rangers 20th in the league on the power play. They just haven't gotten any kind of consistency in their power play.
No, there's very few times where it doesn't look disjointed. Either they're not carrying the puck in properly, or they're not shooting at the right times.
Chris Drury has been moved up front. Avery with a shot, save off the right shoulder of Fleury. Girardi tried to keep it in and was blocked by Jordan Staal. Taken back by Avery. Power play is over. Good penalty kill for Pittsburgh. Drury's pass tipped across. Prucha gets it back to Tuten. Drury toward the net, deflected behind the net. Picked up by Ryan Malone. Game tied 2-2. Crosby playing it across to Sikora. Crosby goes to the front. Good job by Roosevelt. Stayed with him all the way. Crosby against Roosevelt. Great move by Crosby. And then he's shoved to the boards by Hallway.
He got help from Hallway. Good play.
And look at Crosby. Stay with the puck. Hallway shoves him. Roosevelt shoves him. Malone hit by Mark Staal. Good takeaway by Mark Staal. Hallway moves it up. It's taken back. Kept in by Ryan Malone. Good pressure by the Penguins. Malkin. Sikora behind the net. Now it's Malkin. Letang to Orpik. It looks like a power play for Pittsburgh. It's 5-on-5. Saved by Lundqvist. And it's tapped to him by Roosevelt to stop play. 4:24 to go in the second. Rangers and Penguins are tied.
Outwork the other line, get pucks deep, be responsible on both sides of it, and keep the shift short and at a maximum.
Do you sense a level of appreciation from the other guys on the team for what they're getting from that fourth line?
Absolutely. Just the dialogue from the bench of those guys when they're out there, and certainly when they come off the ice after a successful shift. It talks about esprit de corps, the foundation of our team of really, going to bat for each other, and our guys do that.
Tom Reddy talking about using his fourth line to go against other teams' top lines, and we saw it there with the...
They've done a good job. They keep giving Tom Reddy enough confidence that he can continue to use them in that role. And it's a new role for Colton Orr.
Believe they've added an assist to Mark Staal or... on the second goal. And Ryan Hallwig gets a point. First point of the season for that fourth line. Hallwig gets the point. He told us in the locker room today, he predicted he would be the first player of the fourth line to score a point. Shanahan, stopped by Fleury. Good effort by Shanahan around the net.
He hit the post the first time and then got his own rebound.
So they added an assist to Hallwig on the first goal. And Mark Staal got an assist on the second goal. So the first goal now reads Roosevelt from Dubinsky and Hallway. And the second goal, Roosevelt from Avery and Mark Staal.
Here's Brendan Shanahan. Hits the post and then gets his own rebound and tries to jam it in the short side. Ryan Hallway just found out he got his first point of the season. Telling Colton Orr over there on the other side, and Jágr is uninterested or disinterested. That's nothing.
That's right. Penalty call. Penalty upcoming on the Penguins. Good effort by Peter Prucha. He drew it, and the Rangers get another power play, their fifth of the game. Penguins have had only one power play. This is number 5 for the Rangers.
Now the Rangers have to take advantage now. Prucha with the hit. And the stick between the legs.
Rob Scuderi will go.
Yeah.
Now, this morning in the locker room, here's Ryan Hollweg.
I'm going to get it. I feel it tonight. It's going to happen tonight.
That was his bold prediction.
It was an excellent question by you, I might
add. Right. Who's going to... The question was, which guy on your line is going to score the first point of the season? Finally get a point. And he boldly predicted he would get it, and there it is.
Penalty, maybe you should make that a habit. Huh? Morning of the game.
Scuderi for hooking. 16,
go find the player that's in a slump and do your thing.
That's Sam
Rosen effect.
Yeah, I come into the locker room, they run the other way. Gomez, Rangers power play. 0 for 4 with 4 shots. Gomez, Shanahan, and Yager. Mara and Roosevelt. This is Roosevelt. Mara shoots way wide. Roosevelt with both Ranger goals. Pass deflected. Gomez has it back. To Shanahan. Fires to Mara off his stick.
Yeah, it's the second one he missed the net. Mara's going to change the blade on his stick when he gets a chance from that composite, which he's using now, and go back to the old wood blades, which he used to use when he had 15 goals in the season, but he just hasn't had enough time to be able to switch them and practice and use those enough.
I talked to him also. Try to get him going. That's right.
He still has a period or so.
Avery working against Orpik, who had him wrapped up, and the Penguins able to clear the zone.
Why don't you leave the defenseman alone and just take care of the forwards? Defense are doing fine.
Avery. Drury has moved up front on the power play. Had been playing the points and trying to take some pressure off him. Tootin shoots, save, Fleury. Rebound, score! Dan Girardi! It's a power play goal! And the Rangers lead 3-2.
Now that first shot that came from the point was deflected, and Fleury made a good save. He had to kick it off to the side, but Dan Girardi just moved in from the point. And again, now the Rangers, all three goals by defense. Girardi makes the first good play, moves into the zone, and then just dumps it in. Now the Rangers go to work. Avery with work on the boards and some time. And the Rangers will get a shot right here that gets deflected. And just moving up on the play was Dan Girardi. This gets deflected, good save. And Girardi moved up to put it in.
Drury made a nice
Rangers
play.
Yeah, he did, with the stick, right, after the save. Puts the puck right over to Girardi, who took the quick shot.
Girardi's second goal of the season, his second NHL goal. And the Rangers with three goals here in the second period, lead 3-2. Lundqvist tried to knock it away. Mark Stahl moves it. Joe, we're seeing a change, I think, in the Rangers as a team. Look at Girardi, Stahl,
absolutely.
Tootin, and Roosevelt add some offense,
yes,
from the D.
Yes. Tom Rennie talked about that this morning. He said, we've been encouraging our defensemen all season long to join the rush.
Nice play by Strudwick. Malkin gets it back. Malkin deep with Sikora. Back pass. Played in deep by Mark Eaton.
And Sam, you know what's been a big difference in this period than the first period? The whole first period was Sidney Crosby.
Yes.
He hasn't had the puck much in this period. And again, part of the reason might be the fact that Tom Rennie changed up the defense pairing against him and went to Girardi and Tootin.
Fans, just a reminder.
Girardi got the goal from Pruka and Tootin at 18:35. Not sure, but I thought that Drury.
Did you think it was Drury there? I thought it was in front as well.
It was the guy that touched the puck, but nevertheless, it's a power play goal for the Rangers. 1-for-5 on the power play. Pittsburgh, a team that is also dangerous on the power play, has only had one opportunity. Here's Yager. Yager centers, intercepted by Hall. And Adam Hall clears it down the ice. It'll be an icing as the touch is made. 1.3 seconds remaining. Rangers with a 3-2 lead. Two goals by Michael Roosevelt, one by Dan Girardi. After trailing 2-0 in the first period, Yager's had a quiet game. Aaron is the place where he helped the Penguins win 2 Stanley Cup championships, 1991 and 92. And the second period comes to an end, and a total reversal in the game. Michael Roosevelt scored early in the period. He scored a shorthanded goal, and there's Ryan Holwick getting the first point of any member of the fourth line. And this morning I had a chance to talk with Blair Betts and Ryan Holwick about the contributions of the fourth line.
We've been thinking about it here for the last couple of weeks here. I think we were out against New Jersey when they had the empty net, and we had a couple of guys down low behind the goal line in the offensive zone when they had the empty net, and I was thinking about just going down there and trying to score a goal.
I'm going
to
get it. I feel it tonight. It's going to happen tonight.
So who would get the first point? Ryan Holway got an assist on the first goal by Michael Roosevelt. Roosevelt with 2 goals, 1 a shorthanded goal and a power play goal. Now, this is the Mercedes Hockey Night Live intermission report. And it's a pleasure to have Jordan Staal of the Pittsburgh Penguins join us. Jordan, talk about the way that the game changed from the first period to the second.
Well, I mean, just 2 quick goals, and it's a tough way to go. The second period is obviously a huge period, and again, we just got to battle back in the third. I think as long as we get that one first, nice and quick, we can win this game.
Jordan, you had such a great offensive year last year as an 18-year-old. You're still only 19, but you got switched back to center this season as opposed to playing wing last year. How difficult has that been for you?
Well, it's been tough. I mean, it's a new position in the NHL, and I've been playing left wing lately, but you can kind of throw them in different situations and see how I take it. And, center's tough, especially playing against top lines, and hopefully I can do a better job of it.
Jordan, when you go on the ice, are you aware if Mark is on the ice at the same time or not?
Not really. I mean, it's a tight game, and you don't really think about that kind of stuff. And you see him out there every once in a while, but you don't really think about it.
Mark is certainly doing well. Congratulations to you and Mark. And nice to have your parents here tonight. Thanks for joining us. Good luck.
All right, thanks a lot.
Jordan Staal joining us between periods here, where the Rangers lead the Penguins 3-2. We'll be back in just a moment. We are back in Pittsburgh, where New York Rangers hockey is brought to you in part by Oppenheimer Funds. Oppenheimer Funds, the right way to invest. And by Sharp. Introducing the D64 series, the slimmest, lightest Aquas LCD TVs ever. Sam and Joe, John came in from the radio booth to vote for Mika Kiprusoff. Fans like Mika Kiprusoff, Henrik Lundqvist, 2.22 goals against average, NHL's second best over the last 4 seasons. Who's first? What do you think, Joe?
Okay, thanks, Al. Appreciate it.
And you say?
Al's going to give me his points if I get this right.
Yeah.
I'm going with Dominic Hasek.
It's absolutely the Dominator.
How'd you know that?
I know that. Come on. It's the Dominator.
How'd you know that?
Trust me. I know these
You're
things.
You're a smart guy.
I know these
so
things.
So I get double points.
John Ginone out.
Huh? I get double points.
Poor John. Huh? John, step in front. Just say hello to the fans.
There's our guy.
There's John. He's going back to radio. Yeah. Oh, John had to leave Philadelphia, go in to do MSGNY last night, right. Had to stay for double overtime with the Knicks, got out of the studio at 3 in the morning, tried to get on a plane to Pittsburgh today. Plane had technical, it was all fouled up, mechanical problems. Finally got here in the midday.
Right.
So the Gia Wig's not happy. John should not be smiling.
See, this should be 15 because Al gave me an extra point for that.
Joe, right there. No. You don't get Al.
No. Well, Al told
no,
me.
No.
If I got it right, because
no,
he's not.
No.
Well, he told me that.
You're out.
You know how honest Al is.
Only 1 point per question. Oh. Hey, in what? Philadelphia, Devils are leading the Flyers 6-2, and Marty Brodeur is closing in on win number 500. So congratulations to him.
Yeah, there's still about 10 minutes to go in the third period in Philadelphia. And meanwhile, we talked about Sidney Crosby, Sam. In the first period,
I mean, dominant.
He was dominant. He just, every shift, he was dominant. Had a goal and assist. Was getting shots. Hit the post once. Killing penalties. Second period, just the Rangers did a good job against him, plain and simple. I mean, his effort never changes, but the Rangers change. I thought Tom Rennie made an important switch. He played Tootin and Girardi against Crosby in the second period.
And that's what he has right now. Rangers open with Gomez, Avery, and Shanahan, Tootin and Girardi. Penguins have Crosby, Sikora, Crosby with a takeaway, Ryan Malone is the other forward. Rangers take the puck back.
And that was a good play by Girardi. Crosby stole the puck from Gomez from behind. Great little move. And then Girardi with the stick made a nice defensive play on Crosby.
Fans trying to get the Penguins fired up. Rangers send it in. They have been strong with the lead in third periods. Crosby sends it in. Roosevelt pressured by Jordan Staal. And Roosevelt out with the puck. Marcel Hossa after it. Bumps with Scuderi. Scuderi got it to Ryan Whitney and around to Jordan Staal. It's by him. Staal, Malkin, and Recchi on for Pittsburgh. Here's Evgeny Malkin. Pass behind Recchi, and it's out of the zone.
Again, this Pittsburgh team, they've had a difficult time scoring goals this year. Gary Roberts just one on the season. Recchi with two.
Staal.
Jordan Staal, just one goal.
That's right.
Boy, he had a terrific season a year ago. And it's a big difference. You know, the other thing, Sam, he switched to center, and that is a difference. There's more responsibility playing center than wing. The other thing is that the league is more aware of him this year. Getting more attention.
And he's still a youngster. That's Joey's just 19. But what happens is after the nice start he had to his NHL career last year, the expectations immediately grow.
Defensively, he's playing the same. He's a smart player. He knows how to play on the other side of the puck. But he's not getting the offensive chances he did a year ago. And in particular, shorthanded.
Tootin, nice play to get it to Hallwing. And it's chipped clear by Blair Betts. Rangers, when leading after two periods this season, are 6-1. Penguins, when trailing after two periods, 0-7-1.
Rangers fourth line against the top line for Pittsburgh.
Good hit by Girardi on Crosby.
And separates him from the puck, which is difficult to do.
Talked about Girardi and Tootin right at the top. They have become the Rangers' top pair. And they're playing over 20 minutes a game and usually playing against the number one line. If not the number one, then the number two. The puck was knocked away from Gonchar.
Sam, they don't make many mistakes. I mean, every game is virtually the same. When they do make a mistake, it really stands out. It doesn't happen that often.
Gomez dumps it in. Quiet start to the third period. 3:15 gone by. Rangers doing the things right, getting the puck in deep into the Pittsburgh zone.
This is exactly the kind of start the Rangers are looking for.
Good pressure from Dubinsky. Takes the puck back. Fans getting restless here at Mellon Arena. Jágr in good position, anticipated the clear around. Jordan Staal got it away and gets it to Recchi. Recchi against Strudwick. Centers, blocked. Good job by Mara on Jordan Staal. Strudwick to Hossa. Dubinsky to Jágr. Jágr for Hossa went by him. The referee. Raised his arm for penalty and was actually waving that his play was okay.
Raised them both, actually.
Jágr against Malkin. Jágr roughing up Malkin.
Malkin made a good defensive play.
Yeah.
Real good body position on Jágr.
.420 gone by in the third.
Sam, you know, we talked about goaltenders. How about Ilya Bryzgalov, who was put on waivers by Anaheim. He got picked up today at noon by Phoenix, played this afternoon, and led Phoenix to a shutout, 1-0 in Los Angeles.
4:35 gone by in the third, 3-2 Rangers leading it.
Well, we talk about Girardi. That's the steal first, and look at the stick by Girardi. So good, always seems to be in position. That was one play right at his own blue line, and then here's the other one. Body shot on Crosby. Good, solid hit, separates him from the puck, and the Rangers get out of trouble.
Maxime Talbot winds it deep. Talbot and Crosby, the goal scorers for Pittsburgh. Puck centered. Chris Letang works it ahead. Now it's Talbot. Talbot scored a shorthanded goal set up by Crosby. And Crosby scored the second goal. Pittsburgh led 2-0. Girardi's without a stick. His stick is broken. He gets his stick from Nigel Dawes, but it's a left-handed stick. And Girardi's right-handed. Up the boards. It's past Letang and out of the zone, and the Rangers will get out of trouble. They make a change. Talbot sends it in deep. Roosevelt's got the puck. Hit by Ruutu. Stays with the puck. Betts was able to move it out. 5.5 minutes gone by, third period. Rangers leading 3-2. 3 goals in the second period. 2 by Michael Roosevelt, 1 by Dan Girardi. Stahl, Mark Stahl for the Rangers. Bumped by Gary Roberts.
That's
stays
a
with
good
the puck.
Play. Boy, oh boy, he's had a good play. All that pressure for a 20-year-old defenseman, and he just holds on to it, takes a hit, takes another hit, and makes the play.
Roosevelt swings it around the boards for Holwick. Pressure from the Penguins on the forecheck. Rangers get it out of the zone. Past the 6-minute mark of the third period.
Yeah, the Rangers, you see, they're staying together as a fivesome. And especially in the neutral zone, they're just staying out there. They're forcing Pittsburgh to try and make a perfect pass through the neutral zone. And they're right, see, there's another play. They're right there to break it up.
Avery made a fine play, forced the turnover, shot by Shanahan, deflection, and the puck was loose. Fleury lost sight, but a good job by Scuderi. This is Ryan Malone. In against Tootin. Tootin shoves him to the boards. Malone knocked it away from Avery. Tootin trying to work it ahead, but it was blocked. Now Girardi. Around to Gomez. And able to clear it to Avery. Avery moves in. Avery to the goal line. Shoots deflected by Ryan Whitney. Jágr. Checked by Whitney. And it's taken away by Recchi past the 7-minute mark of the third period. Jordan Stahl. Strudwick stays with him. Now it's Jordan Stahl again. Stahl went down. Rangers move the puck. Jágr. For Dubinsky, it's broken up by Letang and cleared out by Orpik. Mara gets back. Malkin steps in. Malkin, offside, offside. Jordan Stahl failed to clear the zone. 12:25 to go in the third. Rangers leading. What's this, Joe?
It's our Panasonic Digital Replay.
Okay.
And this is a lesson. one of many for young Dubinsky. He's learned a lot about playing the game, and this is part of it because he's not afraid. And after he got in a fight with Luke Richardson and got his bell rung.
And Jason Strudwick
says,
instructing him. Jason Strudwick has had many. Then in the second period, Dubinsky went with Jarkko Ruutu.
Did okay, and then seemed to get a little tired there at the end. Ruutu got a couple of shots in on him.
And his instructor and mentor will no doubt have some more work with him. Right here, takeaway, Jágr to Hossa to Jágr. And a good check by Crosby. Jágr's pass blocked. And Malone gets it to Crosby. Nice play with a poke check. Good long stick used by Mark Stahl to knock it away from Crosby past the 8-minute mark of the third period. Rangers leading 3-2.
Now this is Crosby on the ice against Stahl and Roosevelt. That was the matchup most of the first period. Crosby had a good period.
Mark Eaton. fires it low and hard around the boards. Girardi, taken away by Malkin. Gonchar to Jordan Stahl, shot deflected, poked away by Tootin into the corner. Tootin and Malkin along the boards. Here's Gonchar. Eaton winds it around, Tootin there to intercept it. Rangers clear the zone. 9 minutes gone by, third period. Penguins have not had a shot on goal here in the third period. Tootin gets to the line, dumps it in.
The Rangers, we've talked about it, Sam, they're comfortable playing these tight games.
Their defensive work has been outstanding. Here's Erik Christensen moving in. Missed the net with a shot.
He's got a good wrist shot, Christensen.
Off the boards, Talbot. That shot deflected into the corner. Christensen to LaRocque. Pittsburgh's fourth line trying to create something. Good job by Gomez against LaRocque. They bumped into one another, and LaRocque actually went down. Gomez trying to show his strength, and he ran into Brooks Orpik. Gomez almost went down. Fired in by Sean Avery. It deflected and went into the crowd. 10:08 to go in the third period. Rangers leading 3-2.
Sam, you know, we've talked so much about Dan Girardi. One of the changes that he's made this year is he took the face shield off. Last year, he wore the face shield. He wore it in training camp. He wore it 2 years ago as well. And he said, you know, he said, it was something I thought about all summer long. And, you know, it gets a little foggy. Sometimes you get black marks from sticks and pucks. So I just decided to take it off. I said, did you change, maybe think differently after you got hit in the eye? He says, no. He said, even after that, I decided, you know, I'm not going to wear it. He said, I've worn it before and got hit in the eye, and it was worse.
Orpik shot blocked. Kept in by Letang. Mark Stahl there to play it. Hallwig gets it out of the zone. There's been only one shot on goal total here in the third period. That was by the Rangers. Ryan Malone, checked by Roosevelt. Crosby knocked down. Betts did the job. Puck kept in. Orpik to Letang. That shot, that might have gotten through. Looked like a save by Lundqvist.
And then he got knocked down. Lundqvist did after the save by Sikora.
Betts lifts it on the backhand. Out of the zone. Coming down to 9 minutes remaining in the third. 3-2, Rangers leading it. Penguins finally got their first shot on goal of this third period past the midway point. Hossa against Recchi. In deep to Jágr. Jágr winding it to Dubinsky. Dubinsky plays it to Hossa. Off the boards to Jágr. Rangers keeping it deep, not getting any chances though. And the Penguins break out. 3-on-2. Jordan Stahl on the puck. Stahl against Girardi. Deflected. Up into the netting. 8:28 to go. Third period. Rangers with a 3-2 lead. Our game summary looks like this. Rangers have 3 goals by defenseman. Roosevelt 2, Girardi 1. Girardi a goal, 2 shots. Fedor Tootin with an assist and 3 shots. That pair continues to play well. Sidney Crosby, first period, a goal and an assist, 3 shots. Since then, no points, no shots.
Sam, through 2 periods, the Rangers had 21 shots on goal. 12 of those came from the Ranger defense.
And we credit Pete McKevely coming up with the graphics portion of the telecast.
Pete always comes up with good stuff.
Oh, save off the glove of Fleury and a hard shot by Dawes. Here's Dawes again, set up by Prucha, but he went by him. And a whistle and a penalty call.
Against Pittsburgh.
Oh, boy, another Penguins penalty. Rangers get their 6th power play of the game. Evgeny Malkin for hooking.
Yeah, the Penguins in their 3-2 win over the Islanders had just twice they were shorthanded against the Islanders. Hasn't been the same here. Tootin leads the way out of his own zone, quick passing, and the Rangers just continue the pressure. A couple of chances. And Malkin ends up with the taking the penalty, and the Rangers, what an opportunity with 8 minutes to go in this game and up by a goal. If they could get something here on the power play, the way they're playing defensively, it'd make it almost a done deal.
11:50, the time of the penalty to Evgeny Malkin. What a disparity in power play opportunities. This is number six for the Rangers. Penguins have had only one.
Now remember, the Penguins, one of their goals came shorthanded. Yes.
Rangers have a power play goal. They've given up a shorthanded goal. They lead 3-2. Roosevelt and Mara with Shanahan, Gomez, and Yager for the power play. Gomez. Down the boards, past Yager to Shanahan, back to Yager. Pressured by Gonchar. Gonchar and Eaton with Talbot and Ryan Malone for Pittsburgh. Tootin shoots, deflected. Knocked down in front. Talbot plays it off the boards. 50 seconds to go on the power play. 7 minutes to go. Third period. Rangers leading 3-2. Girardi fires in low and hard around the boards. Avery stops it. Dubinsky. Avery. Drury. Girardi and Tootin on for the Rangers. Avery holding the puck. Has an assist in the game. Girardi back to Avery. Avery to Tootin for the shot off the outside of the net. May have gone off the glove of Fleury.
And Sam, right before the shot, they switched sides, Tootin and Girardi. So they were on their offsides, and when the puck ended up coming over to Tootin on the other side, he was able to take the shot almost off the pass and hit the side of the net.
Play was stopped for a hand pass against the Rangers. 6:30 to go in the third, 20 seconds remaining in the power play.
Now you see these two, watch this. How do you like that drawing, Sam?
Nice.
See how they switch there? They switch, and eventually Tootin gets it on his offside, and he's able to get a quick shot.
That's exactly what happened when you drew it. That was perfect.
I've been working on that.
Those artwork getting much better. Final seconds of the power play. Drury along the boards. Now Pruka out with a shot. Saved by Fleury. Team's back at full strength. Malkin. 6 minutes to go, third period, 3-2 Rangers. Nice move by Malkin, and he stopped. Great play by Roosevelt.
Just prior to that, Roosevelt almost had his third of the game.
Rangers 1-for-6 on the power play in the game. They lead it 3-2, 5:45 to go in the third period. Eaton bumped along the boards. Malkin sends it to Erik Christensen. Christensen shot deflected by Mara. Loose in front, deflected on goal. A save, rebound, score! I believe Peter Sikora got the goal on his weird bounce in front.
Well, I think it hit the skate of Colton Orr and into the goaltender Lundqvist. Here's the shot. Let's see who skate. Yes, he hits Colton Orr's skate. And then there's all that havoc in front. And Peter Sikora just follows up. Watch the right skate of Orr. It hits his skate, so the puck goes into the goaltender Lundqvist. And by that time now, the Rangers are scrambling around. And Peter Sikora took advantage of it.
Watch the play Malkin made there. He kicked the puck to Sikora with his skate. Great play by Malkin.
A weird-looking play that ends up in the net. And the Penguins have come back to tie it.
3-3 the score with 5:20 to go in regulation time. Avery got knocked down by Gonchar. And now Mellon Arena has come alive. As the Penguins, who have had only two shots on goal here in the third period, get the tying goal. Tootin and Girardi. There comes Gomez. Gets out away from Recchi. Gains the zone. Avery shoots and it hit his own man. Sikora got the goal, his ninth, from Malkin and Christensen at 14:28. Yager. Mark Stahl drives in. Ball went deep. Avery winds it behind, played by Ryan Whitney. Taken back by Avery. Whitney moves the puck to Malone. Bouncing puck. Mark Stahl takes it away from Evgeny Malkin.
Damn, the Rangers power play again.
And here's Laroc with a shot blocked. What happened was Stahl was moving up with a puck, and then Dubinsky fell down, and Stahl lost the puck. That shot deflects up into the netting. 4:04 to go in the third period. A goal by Peter Sikora has tied it at three. Hey, congratulations to the great Martin Brodeur, the second goaltender in NHL history to reach 500 wins. He got it tonight with a 6-2 win, 26 saves in Philadelphia. Second most wins all time. Now he's after number one, Patrick Roy.
Congratulations to Marty. He's a great guy. He's been a great ambassador for the game of hockey for all these years. And what a goaltender he's been.
Oh, you can't ask to meet a better guy who is easy to talk to and spend time with. And what a great player he's been. And a great champion.
Just play me, coach.
That's all. Let's go Pens chant up from the crowd. 3:45 to go. Game tied, 3-3. Hossa sends it in. Scuderi and Hossa. Good job by Hossa. Christensen there. Dubinsky is there. Hossa continues to work. Puck around to Ryan Whitney and out to Gary Roberts.
By the way, Crosby went off the ice briefly, but returned before the drop of the puck.
Little equipment problem. Gomez lost control, has it back. And the Rangers are offside. 3:09 to go in the third period with the game tied. 3-3, Devils, Rangers, Islanders battle for local supremacy in the Hummer Metro Ice Challenge. Hummer and Madison Square Garden will donate a combined total of $50,000 to the winning team's choice of charity. Next game of the Metro Ice Challenge involving the Rangers is Monday. Rangers and Islanders at Madison Square Garden. Right now, the Islanders are leading the series. They haven't lost to either the Devils or the Rangers.
Patrick Sharp, by the way, scored 3 goals in the third period tonight for Chicago as they go into Detroit and win 5-3.
Wow, big win for them.
That's a good, they're a hardworking, good young team, the Blackhawks. How about every team in the Central Division over 500?
Giveaway to Crosby, and then a good recovery by Roosevelt. Avery with a puck. Shanahan, 2:35 to go. Tied 3-3. Penguins led 2-0 end of the first. Rangers led 3-2 end of the second. And the Penguins have tied it on a goal by Peter Sikora here in the third period at 14:28. Whitney missed the puck. Dawes trying to find it. Almost a disaster for the Penguins.
Now it's late in the period. Puck bouncing and rolling a little bit. That just, I believe, bounced over the stick of Whitney. And now the Rangers take an icing. And so the faceoff will come in the Rangers' zone.
First mental mistake the Rangers have made, I think, here in quite a while. They didn't get to the red line to dump it in. Don't forget, we've got a big doubleheader here on MSG. When we conclude this game, we'll send you out to Denver, where the New York Knicks are playing the Denver Nuggets, right here on MSG. Deep in the Rangers' zone, Girardi with a hit on Gary Roberts, and another one. And Tootin plays the puck with 1:50 to go in regulation time, but not out of the zone. Roberts in deep. Ranger coaches want the defenseman to go forward with the puck, not side to side. Tootin got knocked down by Roberts.
Yeah, Sam, that was actually Nigel Dawes that made that pass, so that lateral pass that stayed in his zone.
1.5 to go, regulation time. Erik Christensen by himself. Penguins changing, plays it deep. Ryan Malone against Strudwick.
And now Crosby on the ice as well.
Sikora's with the puck. Sikora against Strudwick. Taken away by Dubinsky. Pokes it out of the zone. Played by Gonchar with 1:05 to go. Malone for Crosby. Stahl stays with him. Crosby trying to take it back. Jágr is there. Good job by Stahl. And a good job by Ryan Malone to get it back to Crosby. Jágr takes it away. Jágr with a great play in the defensive zone.
Oh, he did. He came all the way back into his zone below the goal line to help out his defenseman. He made a good play.
35 seconds to go in regulation time. 3-3 the score. Stahl stopped Malkin. Roosevelt. Gomez. Poke checked away by Malkin. There's Stahl to recover. Deflected away from Gomez. Jordan Stahl ties up Roosevelt. Roosevelt on his knees, put it in the Penguin zone. Nicely to Malkin. Malkin against Stahl. Save by Lundqvist. And he juggled it and covered up. Oh, 11.3. Stahl left his feet. He went down early. And Malkin had a great chance.
And Lundqvist is arguing that after he made the save, watch the stick of Malkin. After he shoots right there, he chops at it, and that's what knocked the puck free. And that's what Lundqvist was arguing about afterwards. Strong play. And then see that last little whack with the stick?
11.3 seconds remaining. Rangers with 25 shots in the game. Pittsburgh with 23. Shots are only 4-3 here in the third period. In favor of the Rangers. Penguins the only goal here in the third. Hossa clears the zone. Rangers and Penguins go to overtime. Well, well. A good Atlantic Division rivalry. Rangers and the Penguins battling. Each team had the lead. And now they're tied at the end of regulation. We'll be back with overtime right after this. This overtime is brought to you by AIG. AIG for insurance, investments, retirement. AIG, the strength to be there. Rangers and Penguins each get a point out of this game, and the Rangers are now in first place by themselves in the Atlantic Division, moving ahead of Philadelphia. Flyers lost tonight. Now the Rangers and Penguins play for another point.
Well, Pittsburgh came back to tie it in the third. Watch the right skate of Colton Orr. Accidentally, the puck goes off his skate back towards the goaltender. And then what a play by Malkin, Sam. You picked that up where he kicked it right to Sikora, back out to the slot. And Sikora, with their second shot of the period, ties the game at 3. And here we go for overtime.
Rangers 3-1 in overtime. And all four of their overtime games have gone to a shootout. The Penguins are 1-1 in overtime, and their two overtime games, previous two, have gone to a shootout.
Now, this is where you watch Chris Drury.
4-on-4, Drury shot blocked, another shot wide off the glass. 4-on-4 hockey in sudden death overtime. Drury with a hit on Ryan Malone. They both went down. Puck out of the zone, and Sidney Crosby's got it. Through for Malone. Tootin gets over. And help from Girardi. Sean Avery. Avery tried to cut in front. Scuderi picked him up. Penguins goals for Maxim Talbot and Sidney Crosby in the first period. Peter Sikora in the third. Rangers, two goals from Michael Roosevelt, one from Dan Girardi, all in the second period. Jágr taken away by Malkin. Jágr hounding Malkin. Jager's got to be careful. Malkin took a hit from Jordan Stahl. Penguins have had only one power play chance in the entire game.
I think that was Mark Stahl.
Yes. What did I say? Jordan Stahl?
I did?
I can't believe I
That's
said
That's okay.
That. Mark Stahl with a nice play. In deep, Gonchar. Dangerous. Centers, and it's knocked away by Shanahan from Christensen. Avery to Paul Mara. Mara moves in. Pass. Score! Jason Strudwick wins it in overtime. An unlikely hero.
Are you kidding me? Two defensemen breaking up the ice on the 4-on-4. Mara going down one side. Jason Strudwick going down the other side. Who would have thought Jason Strudwick would get a shift in overtime?
Wow.
And the Rangers defense score all four goals in the game to win it in overtime.
That's the story. Rangers defense getting offensive. Two goals for Roosevelt, one for Girardi, and Jason Strudwick converts a great pass from Paul Mara, and the Rangers win it in overtime.
It's about time they played him more.
You're so critical, Joe. Rangers have won five in a row and nine of their last 10.
They find ways to win.
And they are in first place by themselves. The goal of the game is brought to you by Refreshingly Smooth Bud Light. Always worth it. Here it is.
Yeah, the Penguins with the puck in the offensive zone. The pass in front, Shanahan makes the defensive play, and here come the Rangers defensemen. Paul Mara down one side, Jason Strudwick down the other side. Perfect pass, little tap in, 2 points, time to go home.
Here it is again, Gomez starts the play across to Mara.
What a pass, through the legs of the defenseman, right on the tape of Jason Strudwick, who taps it in. And the Rangers four-game road trip, not bad.
Four straight wins on the road at Toronto, at New Jersey, at Philadelphia, and at Pittsburgh. What a beautiful pass from Mara to Strudwick. And the Rangers win it 4-3 at 1:40 of overtime. The Rangers have won five in a row. They are in first place by themselves in the Atlantic Division. We'll be right back. Rangers have now won five in a row, 9 of 10, as they beat the Penguins in overtime. The Oppenheimer Fund's Team Contributor Award goes to Jason Strudwick. Oppenheimer Fund's the right way to invest. Look at that goal. The game winner in overtime.
He looked like a left wing.
He was flying down the ice. Here's Jason Strudwick. How about that goal?
Oh, that's great. You know, it's obviously it's exciting. You know, sometimes we don't get a lot of chance to score for guys like myself, and you know, it's nice to score every now and then, but I'll leave it to the guys that score to do it more often.
Jason, you know, I mean, we've talked about you. You've played left wing a little bit over time. Did that help you a little bit, just the experience of being up there?
Yeah, sure. I mean, you know, you just get used to going to the net. You know, I mean, look, there's two defensemen jumping up in the play there. That doesn't happen very often, but you know, you just go to the net and hope that the guy finds you, and I hope that my stick somehow hits it in, and that time my shovel pushed it in.
Now, four goals by defensemen. What is going on? Are we seeing a transition in the philosophy of the coaching staff here?
No, you know, I think that you got to really try to get scoring from all areas, you know. And you look at the good teams that have successful, they have guys that can score on the back end. You know, I think Rosie is a defenseman that's really underrated in the whole league. I you know, you watch him every night, and he's really he's a great defenseman in my books. Never makes mistakes, and he's got a good shot, so, you know, he's getting going. And Danny Girardi, I mean, I think he has so much potential. Mark Stahl, Tootin, Malik, all these guys. So, you know, we got to try to contribute. And, you know, the forwards have bailed us out lots of times. So, you know, we're just trying to help where we can.
Speaking of forwards, your pupil, Brandon Dubinsky, got into another scrap in this game. How'd he do this time after you gave him a lesson?
Well, I tell you what, I love the way that guy plays. You know, he's very skilled, and he's not afraid of anybody, you know. And, for a young guy to just get in there and do it, I love seeing that. I know everyone on the team loves it. I don't have to give him any pointers. You know, I just try to help him out a little bit. But, you know, fighting is mostly just guts, and he's got a lot more than a lot of guys, that's for sure.
Jason, congratulations on the game winner. Let's hope you get many more.
Yeah, well, let's not get too carried away. We'll take one for now.
Use the same shovel next game.
That one's going home.
Great night for the Rangers and their defense, and that win over the Pittsburgh Penguins puts them in first place, 2 points ahead of the Philadelphia Flyers in the Atlantic Division. Boy, that looks pretty good if you're a New York Rangers fan. Rangers have won five in a row, 9 out of 10, and they stand atop the division. Next game against the Islanders Monday night. Don't forget, the Knicks are coming up next against the Denver Nuggets. Stay tuned for that. Rangers and Islanders Monday night, 7 o'clock game time at Madison Square Garden. And we will join that game in progress. It's just getting underway. A big win for the Rangers here in Pittsburgh. They win it 4-3 in overtime. For Joe Micheletti, this is Sam Rosen. So long, everyone.